Welcome back to this Rift Let's Play. You're Sambo, Seraphis, and joining us, as always, is Tallahassee. How are you this fine Melbourne evening, my good friend?
I'm alright, even though my voice is shot to pieces.
Your voice sounds, well, you know, I guess could be two schools of thought here. One could say, yeah, it sounds shot. And the other could be it's, you know, awfully gruff, husky, you know, that sort of smoky, smouldering, rough voice. Do you know what I mean? Maybe we'll choose the latter.
Yep.
Yeah. Why
yeah,
is
that.
Your...
I'm happy.
Why is your voice like that? Are you ill, my friend?
Yeah, just a bit of a cold and, yeah, sore throat.
Oh, do you know what? Sounds to me like you need to take some time off work. What do you reckon?
Well, Easter's coming, so I've got 4 days off.
Oh, that's right, it is Easter. And in fact, folks, by the way, welcome to this episode. It is, we're filming just ahead of Easter, and don't know about what happens wherever in the world you guys are watching this episode, but here in Australia, we get 4 days off. We get the Friday and the Monday off. Oh boy, can't wait. And of course, Tallahassee, Saturday will be our normal appointment for brunch. I always look forward to that. But do you have any plans for the Friday and the Monday?
Friday, cleaning the house because we have people coming around on the Sunday for lunch.
Are you going to be cooking? Are you going to be Iron Chef over Easter?
Yes.
All right. I've just invited myself, by the way. So thanks for that. I'll be there
on
Sunday.
You're more than welcome.
Oh, actually, I did go to your house for last Easter, and I still remember that. Can't believe it was a year ago, and a magnificent feast, so thank you very much for that. There you go, folks. So yes, Easter is coming up, and speaking of celebrations, by the way, you may have noticed in the foreground here, we've got some other celebratory pets with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer noses, and you can see we're surrounded by Tallahassee's favourite companion pet, but especially this one right in front of me here, Rudy, belonging to Spellatrix. And by the way, in case you didn't know, welcome Scyfo, who's on the other end of Spellatrix, who joins us on voice chat this evening. How are you this fine evening, Scyfo?
I'm great, thank you, Sambo, and how are you, my friend?
Very, very well. Nice of you to come along and pay us a visit here in Rift. You know what? We've never actually caught up with your character in the game. Of course, we watch your Let's Play series and see the adventures that you have there, your high-level adventures. The 40 to 50 bracket, which, Tallahassee, is something that we're aiming for by about 2019, I think.
I thought we actually said that we were going to agree to get there sometime in, you know, 2050.
Oh, okay. Well, I just don't want to push it too much. Don't want to rush. You know me,
no.
Don't want to rush through the game. But Spellatrix is a level 43 mage and looking very fine, I might say. So what is your build? I've been dying to know, actually. Are you a pyro? Are you a chloromancer? What are you?
I'm a dreaded warlock.
Ah, a warlock. You know what? I've got a soft spot for warlocks because that was pretty much one of my first major tunes in WoW, actually. And I don't know, I played that for years and years and years. Tallahassee, you don't really go for warlocks, do you? Dots.
No, I don't.
Tallahassee.
I never played one.
There you go. He knows more dots. Oh, I love that. You know what? It makes me feel like going out and watching that video. More dots! More dots! There you go. Actually, don't say anything, folks. 10 internet points for anyone who can tell us what that is from. What is the more dots, less dots? What is that famous Intertron video to which we refer? Anyway, enough about WoW. We're here to kind of celebrate something that's happened over on your channel, Scyfo. And by the way, folks, if you're watching this episode and wondering what is Skyfo's channel, well, for a start, it's listed in the description below this video, so make sure you hop over there and have a look. Skyfo is a Let's Player just like us, and at the moment, Skyfo, I guess it's fair to say that you're focusing on Rift, but if you had to describe your YouTube channel, what sort of content have you got on there?
Basically, I have a bunch of random crazy videos. That's about it.
We like that. We like random crazy. What's the main sort of focus? Do you focus on any particular games? And, you know, like, I mean, I know you have Rift, quite obviously, but have you done anything else on there?
I've recently started up a WoW Let's Play because I have a whole bunch of different tunes.
And so it's all, is it all MMOs mainly?
No, I also do a Kingdom of Amalur Let's Play and the Skyrim one.
Oh, now, I'm going to interrupt you right there. Tallahassee, how many times have we wondered, obviously, we always wonder what Skyrim's like, because we kind of refuse to play it, but both of us have wondered at one time or another what Kingdoms of Amalur is actually like. So what's your opinion of it so far, Skyfo?
It's fun and certainly interesting, But it is very pretty and very responsive in terms of combat.
It's not a hot bar-based combat system. Is it more real-time action-y oriented?
Yeah, totally action-y combat. But I also wish it had a bit more lore than it does.
Ah, okay. Yeah, well, you see, I'm big on lore. I would love that. But by my understanding, it's a relatively new game in terms of the developers. What is it, Studio 38 or 38 Studios or whatever they're called? I guess maybe they haven't had time to develop it. Maybe it will develop over time, because I understand that the game that's out now is just one part and that it's a whole universe that they've created. Are they actually planning on bringing out more expansions in the future?
Yeah, I think there's actually a downloadable content available right now. It looks like some kind of undead pirate. I haven't really looked into it that much.
Oh, there you go. Good stuff. All right, so comes recommended. I guess if anyone wants to check it out, they can hop along to your Let's Play channel and have a look at some of your episodes there. Now, speaking of your Let's Play channel, the reason we've actually got Scyfo along here with us today is to observe a very special occasion over on your channel, Scyfo. Now, Tallahassee, we were actually talking about this the other day, and we were wondering if perhaps we should get this very special guest on one of our shows so we could help celebrate this momentous occasion. So, Scyfo, maybe you could tell us in your own words, something very significant's happened on your channel recently.
Yeah, I just reached 100 videos uploaded.
Woo! All right! Well done, man. Congratulations. That is fantastic.
Yep, thanks, guys.
That is a great milestone, by the way. 100 Tallahassee. Can you remember back to when we had 100 episodes on the channel? I certainly can, because I remember it being a real milestone.
I can remember that as well. I know. I think most of them back then were DCUO as well.
Yep, and in fact, somebody I know was also in DCUO back then. Cough, Roman over. Anyhow.
Who's that?
Who's that, he says? 100 videos. Seriously, Scyfo, congratulations. That really is an auspicious occasion, momentous moment, and it's a lot of work. Tallahassee and I were talking the other day in one of our other Let's Play series about how we honestly don't think folk realize how much work goes on in the background, you know, when you're producing a Let's Play series. Now, you know, you've reached 100, but as we know, this is actually your second channel now, isn't it?
Yeah, yes, it is.
So you had episodes on your previous channel, which unfortunately ran into a YouTube demise, call it what you will. You lost that channel. Heartbreaking, I'd imagine. How many videos were on there?
I had about 40, and I managed to save about 10.
Oh, dear. Oh, I'm very sorry to hear that. You know what? It breaks my heart when you lose an episode to technological issues, because all those blood, sweat, and tears is all down the drain. But never mind. You've come back like a phoenix, and you've now got 100 episodes on your channel. So I absolutely do believe that's worth a big clap. And congratulations to you, by the way. And, of course, we look forward to 100 more. Have you got any plans on changing up your content at all or adding new games or anything like that? Are you happy with the way it is at the moment?
I definitely want to get into Guild Wars 2 as soon as I can.
Aha, of course you do. And maybe you'll be able to join myself and Reggie and, who knows, maybe even Tallahassee. Tallahassee, have you made up your mind on that one yet? Are you going to join us in Guild Wars 2?
I'm still a bit on the fence. I'd like to try the game out first before I commit to anything.
There you go.
With that game, because I just don't know how it's going to come together.
Yeah. Well, we know you're not the greatest fan of Guild Wars 1, and that's fine. Each to their own, of course. And that's mainly because the game is instanced. And, you know, from what we know, Guild Wars 2 is going to be a lot less instanced. So, hey, who knows? Perhaps it might actually be your cup of tea. But it would be awesome to have you along, of course. Now, before we go any further, we are going to, by the way, have, hopefully, Scyfo, you'll join us for the whole episode. Are you happy to hang around and help us out on our questing today?
Try my best not to kill you all.
Yeah. Thanks. You're going to have to restrain yourself very hard.
If I can survive playing with Sambo, I think I can handle you.
Thanks.
Okay, great.
Thanks, mate. Really appreciate that. You know what? Look, you're supposed to be nice to me. Look who I brought out, especially for you. Look, it's Courage. It's your favourite. It's the dead-eyed harbinger of doom, especially for you. So you be nice to me. Now, speaking of being nice, just got a couple of quick
shouts. Oh, my God.
Oh, wait, he's gone. Where'd he go? Did you jump off?
He's bailed.
Yeah, I've just gotten away from Courage. That jump from that balcony should have killed me.
Yeah, I see you got down to 30% health there, you brute of a man. I can see you. There he goes, folks. Look, he's all the way down there. There he is. That's right. He'll make his way back up because I believe, by the way, Tallahassee, the other reason we're here in Sanctum is we've got to train, haven't we? It's been so long since we've actually done any training. Tallahassee grabbed me by the ears and he said, get thee to Sanctum because we've got to do some training. So we'll do that. Before we go on, we just got a couple of shout outs here. First one is from BlizzardWolf78 and they say, hey guys, love your Rift Let's Play series. I just started playing Rift and thanks to you, I love it a lot. Can you please give me a shout out on the series at some point? And if I see you, I will praise you like a god. All right, now did you hear that, Tallahassee? I'm going to hold him to that. BlizzardWolf78, if he sees us, I think he's got to get down on his knees and pray to us like a god. We like the sound of that. But thank you very much for your support, BlizzardWolf78. Got another shout out here from Super Ruthless Gaming, and they say, hey Sambo and Tallahassee, can you guys please give me a shout out? Just started playing Age of Empires Online. I'm a huge fan of what you guys do, and keep up the great work. And that's from Super Ruthless Gaming. Thank you very much for your support. And speaking of Age of Empires Online, Tallahassee, I see it very popular on Steam at the moment. Have you given that game a go yet?
Welcome
back. You haven't? No, what about you, Scyfo? Yep. Have you played any Age of Empires Online? Do you know what the fuss is about?
Well, I only played it during beta, and I am not too fussed on doing it again.
I see. All right. I'll take that as a polite no then. So there you go. I must admit, I've only played it during beta. Wasn't too fussed on it then either, but I might give it another go. Let us know in the comments below if you do play it and what you think of it now. And then finally, we've got one more shout out here from WowLord94, and they say, hey guys, why don't you do a tank, Sambo, and Tallahassee do DPS? Can you please give me a shout out in Rift and okay, look, clearly this guy's delusional. WowLord94, you've obviously had a hit to the head because he's saying here, can you tell Tallahassee he is cool? What? I mean, clearly this guy's delusional. Are you kidding me? Come on. What do you have to say about that, Tallahassee?
No, I'm not cool. I'm awesome.
Actually, you know what, WowLord94, probably Tallahassee would be the last person in the world to think he's cool. That is exactly right. But there you go. Big shout out to you, and thank you all for your support, by the way. And thanks, too, for your support with our Rift 1 year anniversary episode. Big reaction there on the 1 year anniversary episode. So thank you all very much for the wonderful comments and the feedback that we got from that. You know what, we had a lot of fun, didn't we, Tallahassee, filming that one with all of the guys and gals from Seraphim, basically in their underwear. I think, do you think that's become a tradition for Seraphim?
I think it has.
A disturbing tradition, by the way. And see, obviously, Scyfo, you're in Seraphim. Just reminding you guys watching from a home. Oh my God, he's got his big white undies. Save us from the big white undies. If you would like to join Seraphim, come along and take part of all the shenanigans that we get up to here in Rift on the Lathis server. All you have to do is click the link below in the description. Of course, head along to the Seraphim website there, the community website, and apply. Tell them that you've never heard of Tallahassee or Sambo, and you'll more likely get in. Anyhow, folks, let's head on in. Tallahassee, we've got to do some training, I believe. I've got some mage training to do, and obviously you've got some warrior training. Now, how long do you reckon it's been since we've actually done this? Too long?
Yeah, for you, probably too long.
Okay, where's my trainer? I don't even know where it is.
Over here.
Oh, okay, whoops. There we go, mage trainer. So yeah, folks, don't forget to train. Unlike us, if you're sort of out in the world doing a lot of questing, it can be quite easy to sort of not be bothered coming back. But you are doing yourself a disservice, of course, because as you'll see here, here we go, I'd like to train four. There we go. You can see I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Four of my spells there that need ranking up. And of course, that means I'm doing less damage than I potentially could. And that is a bad thing, especially when you've got Tallahassee whinging at me all the time to get my DPS up. So there we go. Four new skills. Now, what about you, Scyfo? Are you a good boy? Do you tend to remember to come home to do training?
No, I also had four new skills. Old skills that needed ranking up.
Well, there you go. There you go, just as well you came along. All right. Well, I'm done. How about you, Tallahassee?
Yeah, I'm done as well.
All right, so I think it's now time to have a look in our quest log, folks. Let's see here. And of course, you might remember we're in the Moonshade Highlands. Here we go. Let's open up our map And there we go. You can see we're down in Sanctum. Now, can we actually take a porticulum over to where we need to go? Where's that? Three Springs. Do you think that's going to be faster than riding into the Moonshade Highlands over here to...
Yeah, okay.
So we'll do that. And you can see we're heading over there into slightly new area, by the way, folks, of the Moonshade Highlands here. We've got to kill ghostly horrors and we've got to collect the Queen's Tiara. So that's what we're doing. So yes, let's porticulum over. Just going to jump down here. Now, when I logged in, I noticed that there was, on the patcher, a mention of patch 1.8. And hang on, we'll just... Where are we going? We're going to Moonshade Highlands. There we go. There was a mention of patch 1.8 and... Oh, I'm jumping up and down. I'm all excited because I read something about the new skills. And we've touched on this, Tallahassee, in a couple of episodes. And by the way, following you to our quest objectives. And poor old Scyfo won't know where we're going because you've probably done all these already. But there was a mention of the fishing. The fishing. Which, of course, we all know is Tallahassee's favourite MMO occupation. When is Tallahassee? When is that patch due? Do you have any idea?
No idea. It's still on the PTS.
Okay. What about you, Scyfo?
Soon, maybe.
Yeah, have you heard anything?
Yeah, it's on the PTS. But also, I want to say that I love fishing in MMOs.
Aha! All right, I've got an ally. 2-1 there, Tallahassee. You know what? I absolutely adore it. And by the way, what's this? Is this a... Where's the mobs? Oh, do we have to summon it, don't we? Planar lure. Here we go. All right, and of course, folks, this is great. This is all part of the random nature of Rift that we love so much. And that is actual rifts that pop up. And you can see we've summoned this one here. And my God, I nearly got squashed by a tree appearing on top of me there. So, of course, whilst we are on our way over to our quest objectives, what's to stop us from actually taking part in a rift? Now, let's see if we can test Skyfo's knowledge. I'm going to put you on the spot here, my friend. Why would we want to do a rift? If we've got people out there who are watching this episode saying, well, hang on, what's the point in doing a rift? How would you describe it, Scyfo? What's the point?
I have some value of breaking up the questing, whole questing thing, and it also grants you some planar loot, I think it is.
That's the one. Both very good answers, by the way. We'll give you 10 out of 10 points for that one. And you know what? I like the fact that, yes, you can get the planar essences and, you know, go to the vendor and get some really nice gear. As Tallahassee rounds up the entire zone... Let's get some dots on these guys. So yes, there is that, but you know what, you make a really good point there, Scyfo, which, as everyone will say, you run a risk in any MMO of burnout. If you do the same thing over and over, if you're doing dailies over and over and over, the same content, doesn't matter how good the game is, you're going to burn out. Rift seems to understand that and breaks up all of the activities by giving you things just like this. So if you've never played Rift before and you're wondering what the heck is going on, this is the namesake of the game. This is a rift. You can summon it, and you can see here we're going through various stages, which get more and more difficult each time. And you can see up the top here, I've actually already got some loot, and we're able to take that to a loot vendor. Whoops. A loot vendor and get some really nice gear. So it's lots and lots of fun. And now, by the way, if you look on the map, you'll see these. See that up there? That's a water rift. That's what they look like on the map. So you can always tell where the rifts are. And in fact, I know a lot of people, Tallahassee, I'd like to know if you've ever done this, who just log in for something different to do. They just log in and purely sort of do an hour's worth of rifting. Have you ever done that? And no quests?
Yeah.
I mean, it can be quite fun. It's kind of like that feeling you get when you run a dungeon. You know, like a real sense of achievement. And you get some fat loots at the end of it. And let's face it, folks, at the end of the day, that's probably what a lot of MMOs are about. What about you, Scyfo? Are you a Rift fan, as in quite literally rifting in the game? Or, you know, what's your favourite type of activity in Rift? Is it dungeons? Is it rifts? Is it world events? Is it questing? Have you got a favourite?
Yeah, I do enjoy the rifts. I think when the beta was in, I just did rifts all the time with everyone else. It was amazing. Huge groups of people.
Yeah, there you go. And it is most fun when there are tons and tons of people. Do you remember, Tallahassee, back in the day when we were doing rifts, back in the starting zones, etc.? And by the way, look at that, folks. Look at all that loot. And the rift has gone. You will see it disappear from the ground. Very cool effects. If we just watch the ground there, you'll see it slowly start. The Zerg creep there will slowly start to disappear. Tallahassee, you remember back in the old days, you know, basically after Rift had been released, and we were doing those rifts in, I think it was Argent Glade or whatever it's called, and there were like dozens and dozens of people doing the rifts. Do you remember those days?
Yeah, those were the good old days.
They were. Sadly, of course, which is basically par for the course with any MMO. Don't tend to see quite as many people on the rifts, but don't let that fool you, folks. Don't think for one second that Rift is a ghost town. There are, as you saw in Sanctum, there are still lots and lots and lots of active players. And in fact, do you know what? That's probably another thing we need to do, Tallahassee. I was just going to say, you know, when you use the dungeon finder, you tend to find that the queues aren't too bad. Are we overdue for doing a dungeon run?
We are.
All right, bad us. Bad us.
Are.
Naughty, naughty us. We will do that, folks. In fact, a couple of you have mentioned in the comments below, you know, when are you going to do a dungeon? You're going to be too high to do the one we were going to do. And you're probably right. I think perhaps we should commit to do that in the next couple of weeks. Tallahassee, do you reckon we could rope some of the Seraphim boys and girls to help us out?
Yeah, I'm pretty certain we can do that.
And perhaps even your good self. Actually, Spellatrix, are you going to be... What are you? You're about five levels away from us. Are you going to be able to share a dungeon run with us at your level?
Sure, I think I can tag along, yeah.
Like, I can't remember if there are actual restrictions like there are in WoW. Tallahassee, you're probably the best person to ask there. If Scyfo got too high, would he not be able to come and join us in a dungeon?
No, he'd just need to run to the entrance, basically.
So the gating, in terms of the leveling, is all about the ease of getting there, but there are no restrictions once you're there type thing.
That's it.
All right, that's actually a really refreshing view on dungeons, because most, as you know, especially WoW, of course, will lock you out in terms of dungeon finding, especially when you get to a certain level. It basically disappears off the list. It could be a bit annoying. Anyway, back to our quest. You can see we're killing these deranged fairies and ghostly horrors. And they are 7 out of 15 and 1 out of... 8 out of 15 now and 1 out of 10 respectively. So we are running short on time for our episode. As always, it's just horrible. Rift goes too fast when you're playing it, but I think we'll have enough time to finish off, hopefully finish off this quest. And again, folks, if you have a look on the map, you can see we're slowly starting to move into the fog of war here in the Moonshade Highlands. In fact, you can see we've got a quest tick up there, which is quite clearly a cookie crumb that's going to take us up into the very north of the Moonshade Highlands. Now, Scyfo, I'd imagine you're a little bit ahead of us. Have you quested throughout here before?
It's really good.
Yeah. You know what? We've been here in this particular part of the zone for so many episodes, and there is still content coming out of the damn thing. Can't believe it. It's absolutely incredible. Have you been further north than us?
I'm currently at the Iron Pine Peaks, which is a nice snowy area.
Ah, now, a lot of people say, oh gosh, can't wait for you to see the Iron Pine Peaks, Sambo. And you know what? I'm looking forward to it as well, because of course, snow is one of my favorites. There's no doubt about it. But Tallahassee, I have a memory of you taking me to a very twisty-turny lift at one point somewhere. And we went up the top of that lift and we saw a snowy zone. Was that Iron Pine Peaks?
Yeah, that was the very start of Iron Pine Peaks.
Oh, you know, it was so close at that time, yet it's so far away. Are we going to be heading there after we've done with this zone, Tallahassee?
It depends. We've got options.
Oh, and by the way, that offered a quest.
Depending on our level, yep, which I've gone ahead and grabbed, but depending on our level, we could go there, or we could actually head to another area as well.
Oh, hang on. Are you suggesting that I'd have to either choose snow or... Well, unless is the other area snow?
No, it's not.
All right, well, see, that's a real easy decision. As far as I'm concerned, if there's snow, that's where I want to go. I love snow, because, of course, you've teased me with that little snippet of it when we got to the top of that lift, and I've been pretty much looking forward to seeing it ever since then, so hell or high water won't keep me away from that zone, I tell you that much. But is it actually a good zone? Scyfo, you say you're there at the moment. Are you actually enjoying it as a zone, let alone the aesthetics?
Yeah, I am. It's quite a good, vast amount of quests, and I like the lore around there. There's lots of yetis.
Wait. There's what?
Yetis.
Great. Tallahassee, you conveniently left that particular fact out of Iron Peak's description, didn't you? Did you do that deliberately?
Yes, I did.
You're a butt. That's what you are. Oh, man, that is no good. By the way, we need to kill these ghostly horrors up here. Can't believe it, and hopefully you guys know that Yetis are... I'm scarred from a young age. I saw a movie when I was very young called Sasquatch, and it quite literally scarred me for life. I know that's a colloquial saying, but it really did. I completely freak out when it comes to Yetis, and it's all because of that movie I saw. So, oh my lord, Yetis, thanks. All right, so maybe we won't go to that zone after all. Oh, I don't know. I think I put snow above Yetis. We'll see how we go.
Now, you're such a big girl.
Shush you. I can see these big blobby things. Oh, they're the prisons that we need for our quest, aren't they? So,
yep.
Rescue sacrificial prisoners. Okay, so they're being holed up in these vine cages here, which is very cool. And there we go, Tallahassee. Oh, my lord. Okay, Tallahassee, once you've stopped fighting those mobs, I want you to turn around and have a look out over the lake and tell me what zone that reminds you of. And oh, my lord, Spellatrix. What the heck are you wearing, man? That's amazing. What is that?
The Guise of Death. I want that in the iPhone app.
Oh, the iPhone app. You know what? That's something I've got to do, because, of course, you can win prizes there. Tallahassee, have you been playing any games in the app?
Yes, I have.
Have you won anything?
Yeah, you basically win a lot. Mainly Planarite, inscribed Source Stones, which is used for buying gear. Yeah, that's pretty much all I win.
Very cool, though. Very cool, isn't it? That's, you know what, that is an awesome outfit, by the way, Scyfo. I'm very jealous. I'm going to have to get working on the app. Whoa! What was that you've put on us? Nedra's Might, was it? I'm not sure. It looks very awesome,
yep.
Though.
Might.
Yeah, very nice indeed. Look, we've run out of time, guys, but before we do, as you look out over this view here, Tallahassee, oh, look at that, he's gone and made friends again. What zone, seriously, what zone does that remind you of from another game? Go on.
Zangara Marsh.
Yes, it is from WoW. What do you think, Scyfo? Have you played the Burning Crusade content in WoW?
Yes, I have, and ZZ Marsh is one of my favorite zones.
Yeah, it is too. I love the soundtrack in there. It's one of the reasons I love it so much. Anyway, folks, we're well out of time. Let's wrap this up. You can see, folks, we've got still a number of tasks to do here. Where are we? We're still in the Faering Woods. That's okay. You can see we've still got to rescue a couple of sacrificial prisoners. We've got to kill, four more ghostly horrors. We've got all of our deranged fairies, and we've also got to collect an amulet and a tiara, as well as speaking to General Stanig in the Faering Woods, which is just a little bit north of us here. So plenty more to do. If we have a look at the map, you can see it's all around here, and hopefully very soon we'll start unlocking some of this northern area of the Moonshade Highlands, and looking forward to that. There you go, folks. We're trained up. It was nice to have you along, by the way, Scyfo. Thank you very much for joining us in this episode.
Thank you for having me. It's been fun.
Good stuff. And by the way, once again, congratulations, big congratulations to you for 100 episodes. A huge milestone on your Let's Play channel. And don't forget, folks, to hop along there and support another fellow Let's Player, by the way. And I can certainly vouch for the fact that Scyfo's Let's Play series are top quality, very clear recordings, very concise commentary. And I'm a huge fan. So thank you for producing those, by the way, Scyfo. Good to see you. Hopefully we'll see you again. Will you come back and join us another day?
Anytime.
Good stuff. Glad to hear it. So there we are, folks. We're done. Thank you very much for joining us in this episode. Of course, certainly hope you'll join us in the next one. More importantly, hope you're having a great day wherever in the world you are. On behalf of myself, Sambo, Seraphis, Scyfo, and of course, as always, Tallahassee, it's us saying take care. We'll see you next time, and bye-bye.